That's a smart kid. Hey. Los again, and today we're going to be talking about the Kevin Durant review part one. Now, today we're going to be talking about Kevin Durant. Now, the situation for Kevin Durant. First of all, I don't have the appropriate outfit on for this video, so hang on. Okay, now I have the appropriate outfit on for this video. Anyway, that's not what we're talking about today. Today, we're gonna be talking about Kevin Durant, like I already said. Okay, now, like Stephen A. said, he was like, they were on ESPN. They were talking about how, oh, the Warriors can't win without Durant. Durant, going to go back, yeah, the Warriors won in 16, I mean 15, but that was like 4 years ago. And now that they have Durant, they're able to take over the game with Durant and Curry, or really it's just Durant. And he's saying that if the Warriors didn't have Durant, we'd lose. And basically, he's like, if you go back now, the Warriors always struggle with teams. Like the Rockets, he's like, we're probably gonna lose against Milwaukee. He didn't think he's gonna beat the Rockets. He didn't think he's gonna beat the Clippers without Durant. He obviously thinks that we're gonna lose the finals without Durant. It doesn't matter who we play. He's like, nah, the Warriors are gonna lose. They need Durant. And Durant and knows that if, he leaves, he won't be in Curry's shadow anymore. He knows that if he does that, he wants to be known as the best player in the world. This guy right here, he wants to be known as the best player in the world. So he knows that he can't do that if he's behind Curry, like he's Curry's shadow. And he's basically saying like he's gonna leave the Warriors. He's probably gonna go to the Knicks, Lakers. He's basically all everyone's saying he's gonna go to the Knicks, and I'm like, okay, look. If he knows to leave, then yeah, he's gonna be his own like team. It's gonna be his team. But you're not gonna make the playoffs. You're not gonna make it to the championship anytime soon. So why leave the Warriors and then go to the Knicks when you can just stay with the Warriors? Yeah, you're gonna create your own legend there and stuff, but what's that worth if you're not gonna go to the playoffs or win a championship, you know? And you have to have good teammates to do that, obviously. And they're saying that we Warriors wouldn't win without Durant. And every time he says that, Warriors fans always bring up 4 years ago, and he's like, "That's 4 years ago. What about now?" It's like obviously you can't. Someone can't win without somebody else. That's how it works. Like the Lakers can't win without LeBron. The Nets couldn't win without D'Angelo. Like it's pretty obvious. So apparently right now they're saying that Durant's gonna tired of being behind Curry's shadow and and all that stuff, and that he's gonna leave and go to the Knicks. Create his own legacy there. I'm like, okay, fine, leave. We don't need him. We obviously, how about those times that we beat the Rockets in 2016 playoffs? 4-2. How about the next year that we beat him? 17, we didn't have Durant for two games and we beat him. This year, we didn't have Durant or Iguodala when he was playing the Rockets twice. They were up 3-2 that year. I think that's that year. But that year, we didn't have Durant. And we were down 3-2. We came back from a 3-2 and came back and beat them. And guess what? That third, fourth game, or that fifth game, was at the Rockets both games. And we beat them without Durant. Now, go to this year. We were playing the Rockets again. Two games we didn't have Durant. The first game, we had him. But then he left, and it was like in the third quarter, and we beat him. Then the next game, we didn't have Durant, and we beat him. And look at this. We just beat the swept the Blazers without Durant. Without Durant. He just doesn't want to admit that we can win without them. And of course, he always like, yeah, they went 73-9, but that was 4 years ago. He's not bringing up the few, like, the now. We clearly beat them without Durant. We swept the Blazers. That's the only team we swept. And when we had Durant, we lost a total of 4 games. 2 against the Clippers and 2 against the Rockets. That we had Durant and we lost. So obviously, if we would have had just Curry, we probably would have swept them. Because I'm pretty sure that the Blazers are way better than the Clippers and the Rockets. So it's kind of like, with Durant, we lose. But without Durant, the whole series, we came back. We broke a record for the most consecutive games with comeback with a 13-plus deficit. Without Durant, Draymond got a triple-double and Curry, and they broke a record. Without Durant, but with Durant, no, we always lose, apparently. Like, the first game that he ever came in the Warriors, we got destroyed by the Spurs. That was with Durant. Without Durant, we're always winning. Every time we have Durant, it's a close game. But see, he doesn't want to bring that up because he's supposed to create all this drama. Obviously, when we have him, we lose. But when we don't have him, we obviously win because we just swept the Blazers. Oh, he's not going to be here the first game. It's going to be tough for the Warriors. Well, obviously, we can win without Durant. But when we had Durant with the Clippers and the Rockets, we obviously lost 2 games each series. But when we don't have Durant, we sweep them. So I was thinking of, what if we didn't have Durant with those series? Yeah, Kevin Durant came back and like destroyed them, but he couldn't have done it without Curry and Klay, obviously. So his points are dumb. Like, we obviously can win a series without Durant. We've been doing it for how long? We obviously can win in a playoffs. And those two series, we lost 2 games, both with Durant. And so yeah, it's like kind of like. And now with the finals, they're saying that he's not going to be in playing for the first game of the finals. That's fine. We swept the Blazers. We did it in the past. Obviously, 16. We had to make it through the playoffs without Durant. 17, we did play games without Durant. So, I mean, it's kind of pointless, you know? Saying that we can't win without Durant, we obviously can. People say that we're a better team without Durant. I kind of agree. It's Curry and Klay's team. It's always been their team. And Steve Kerr's team, it's always been their team. It's always been Curry's and Klay's team. That's what Durant's mad about. He doesn't want it to be their team. He wants it to be his team. So, that's why he wants to go to the Knicks, because he wants it to be his team. That's fine, sure, go to the Knicks. You're not going to win no rings or no playoff championships. By that, I mean the conference championship, but yeah. So, I still like Durant, but what is going on right now, it's kind of like obviously, we can win without Durant. We've been doing that since 16 and 14 and 13. So, yeah. But anyway, that's going to do it for today's video. This is going to be Kevin Durant's review part one. If not already, subscribe. Smash that like button. That's what I was going to say. Don't forget to share this video. Comment what you want me to do next. And I know I was going to say upload every week, but I decided to make this video just because I want to get one out, because we're not going to be here. I'm not going to be here Saturday. We're going to our Christie's. We're going to be gone Saturday and Sunday. Saturday, we're going to come home, but I probably won't upload anyway. Then Sunday, we're going to go with them on a boat and like swim and stuff and fish out on the lake. The big lake, obviously, but yeah. But, yeah, my goal this year is to hit 1K subs, so if we can do that, that'd be freaking amazing. I love you guys so much. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, MarkLosi_YouTube. Follow me on Twitter, MarkLosi. I'll see you all in my next banger video. Peace.